India is a country with diversity. We find all types of cultures, clothing and food habits. Globalization has added a lot to our food menu also. Non-vegetarian dishes are common along with vegetarian items. Beef and pork are not that popular in India compared to Western countries. Hence, goat, sheep, chicken and fish are the main source of non-vegetarian food. Availability of wild animals has come down drastically. Traditional animal husbandry is losing its base against commercial monocropping system of modern agriculture. Even the villagers are depending on chicken mutton stalls of cities. This has created a tremendous scope for commercial poultry, goat and sheep farms. This documentary film by Ashramajivi visualizes each and every detail of goat farming. Goat is the first domesticated animal even earlier to the cow. We still find related animal species in the forest. Goat is the hardy creature compared to sheep and cattle. It prefers the driest climate. Even then, it can survive in heavy rainfall area under protected rearing system. We do not find sheep in forest region and coastal belt. But goat farms are seen here and there. Organic agriculture needs dung and manures. If you go for dairying for manure purpose, it works out costly. Hence, many farmers are going for sheep and goat for manure production. These small ruminants are like debit cards for farmers. Goat is popular for milk also. Surplus milk after feeding the kids is for the farmer. Hence it is called as poor man's cow. Fat globules of goat milk are small and hence it is easily digestible. It has some antifungal and antibacterial properties also. Goat milk is good for allergy and asthma patients. Goat can be milked at any time and any number of times a day. Even then, milk production from goat is not a commercial activity in India on large scale. We do not have separate breed for milk. All are dual breeds. Meat and leather are the commercial products of goat. China is the world number one in goat farming. India stands second. According to the animal census of 2003, China has 19.5 crore and we have 12.5 crore goats. Population of goat is double to that of sheep in India. West Bengal has 1.9 crore, Rajasthan 1.7 crore and Uttar Pradesh has 1.3 crore population of goats. Karnataka has 45 lakh goats, which is almost half of the sheep population. Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka are popular for sheep. But now, goat farming is getting momentum. Goats from these states are being sold in neighboring states. Goat prefers to browse on leaves at height and likes herbage with more fibers. Grazing on the ground is hardly 10%, but it can be reared only with green grass in stall feeding system. Leaves need not be given. Goat needs double amount of fodder compared to sheep. And also the speed of growth is fast. Goat meat is slightly fibrous and hard, but the fat content is less and hence is good for health. Minimum 2 kids per kidding is the major advantage of goat. It gives even 3 to 4 kids sometimes. Hence, the multiplication of goat is very fast. Milk production is sufficient even if it has 2 to 3 kids. Goat has some peculiar naughty behavior. It is very sharp and active. More care is necessary on health management. Disease resistance is good, but the vaccination and regular deworming is compulsory. Kid mortality is more if enough attention is not given. Forest area is decreasing every year, which has affected traditional goat farming. The forest department avoids browsing in the forest, but the scope for stall-fed goat farming is excellent. Traditional or grazing method of sheep and goat farming is in trouble due to shortage of labor and grazing land. Forest is fenced in many states to avoid browsing. Goats come back with half stomach filled in summer. It is difficult to get even drinking water. Pathogen and parasite infestation is more in grazing goats. Problem of worms is persistent in forest regions and areas with medium and heavy rainfall. Spreading of contagious disease is more and fast in the grazing herd. Growth is slow and less, even though the cost of rearing is less. Most of the traditional farmers keeping goat and sheep are landless and poor people. They do not provide fodder and feed at home. Grazing goats spend a lot of energy on wandering for food. Traditional farmers depend on local breeds which cannot gain more weight. Though it is the livelihood for them, it rarely gets commercial importance. Hence, stall feeding is the only solution for commercial and viable farming of goats. This documentary film explains stall-fed system of goat rearing in detail. First, let us study the suitable climate for goats. Basically, goat is comfortable in dry climate, but it tolerates low temperature. Humid condition is not suitable. However, goat farming is possible under stall feeding with platform system in heavy rainfall regions. Of course, the goat can tolerate higher humidity than sheep. These small ruminants suffer with problems like cold, cough, HS, CCPP, etc. in marshy places. Low temperature with less humidity is acceptable. Now, let us see the housing for goats. By nature, it prefers to stay at height above the ground. But still, it can be reared successfully on ground in dry regions. In heavy rainfall areas with high humidity, platform system is inevitable. This is a farm near Salem, Tamil Nadu. Though it is a very dry place, every farm had adapted platform system. Slotted wooden platform is at 5 feet high above the ground. In China, fiber platform is in use. Urine and pellets drop down and the goats remain clean. Collect the pellets every day or at least once in a week. In this method, goat is free from ammonia smell of the urine. Goats remain healthy. Mud flow is good. It absorbs the urine. If the height of the platform is 5 feet, cleaning is easy. Let the height of the shed be 8 to 10 feet in the middle and 5 to 6 feet on either side. This height is necessary to avoid heat during hot summer. Let the shed be in east-west direction in length to avoid direct sun inside the shed. Even the pellets on the ground keep moist. Roof may be of AC sheet, tiles or palm leaves. Each adult goat needs 10 square feet built-up space. This platform system accommodates more number of goats. Open paddock of double size next to the shed is necessary. Trees around the farm keep the atmosphere cool. Put wire mesh fence covering the shed and paddock. These types of wooden steps are made for the entry and exit of goats. Steps like this are better for pregnant does. Let the door of the shed be kept open always, so that the goats come out and go inside as and when they feel. If the bench-like structure is made in the paddock, goats get on and sleep. This farmer provides feed and water in the paddock itself. Shed is only for night stay. This is good for clean maintenance of the shed. Goats are kept in separate groups based on sex, age and body weight. Hence, necessary partitions are made in the goat shed. Feeding is given by keeping the goats inside the shed in this farm. Troughs are attached from outside all along the length of the shed like this. Feeding is easy and shed remains clean. This is GI trough. Cleaning and maintenance is a bit difficult, but can be fabricated in any size and shape. These are halved PVC pipes of 10-inch diameter. Maintenance is easy and durability is more. But the depth is less and hence the wastage of feed is more. It is better to go for 12-inch PVC pipe. Drinking water may also be given in these troughs itself. Clean the feeders before feeding once in a day. Now, let us study the breeds of goat. Beetle, Jamnapari, Shirohi, Talacheri, etc. are the popular breeds of India. Few farmers have world popular breeds like Boyer and Damascus. Deccani, Usmanabadi, etc. are the local breeds of Karnataka. Likewise, each state has its own breed. But these gain maximum of 30 kilograms in 2 years. Hence, they are not viable for commercial farming. Crossbreed kids grow better and fast. Hence, go for crossbreeding for commercial goat farming. Now, let us go in detail about the goat breeds suitable for stall-fed system. This is Talacheri goat, a popular breed of South India. Though it produces good amount of milk, it is a meat breed. Talacheri goats are seen in white, brown and black colors. Tip of the ear is in V or U shape. Doe gains 40 to 45 kilograms and the buck 60 to 70 kilograms. Buck can grow up to 100 kilograms. Dressed meat yield is 60%. Meat is smooth and expands while cooking. It is an attractive rose color. Disease resistance and adaptability of Talacheri breed is excellent. It gives minimum of 2 kids per kidding. Often, it delivers 3 to 4 kids. This is Shirohi buck. Body color and shape are very attractive. Shirohi doe yields more milk and the growth is also better. Average body weight is 70 to 80 kilograms. It can gain up to 100 to 120 kilograms. Taste of the meat is good. Only 1 kid per kidding in purebred is the main drawback of Shirohi. But its crossbreed gives 2 kids. Since milk yield is more, doe takes 3 to 4 months to come into estrus after kidding. Hence, a maximum 3 kidding is possible in 2 years. Shirohi goat adapts very well to various climatic conditions. These are Jamnapari goats from Uttar Pradesh. This grows to a size of a small cow. This being a milk breed, yields 2 to 2.5 liters of milk per day. Doe needs 4 to 5 months to come into estrus after kidding. Roman nose, long ears, and bunch of hair on the back are the characteristics of Jamnapari breed. Ears close the eyes while feeding on ground, which is called ear blindness. It cannot graze short grass because of Roman nose. But there is no problem in stall feeding system. Jamnapari goat gives 1 kid per kidding generally. two kids are very rare. This big goat gains up to 100 to 120 kilograms body weight. 90 to 100 kilograms is very common. Sometimes, this big body size itself is a problem for marketing. Meat is fibrous and hard, and hence it is not preferred in some regions. Due to the body size and growth rate, it needs more feed and fodder. Adaptability in various climatic conditions is also poor. Jamnapari is a fancy breed in many regions and is being used for crossbreeding. This is Boyo breed from Australia. It is a dwarf goat with attractive body color and shape. Boyo is a world popular meat breed which gains 100 to 120 kilograms body weight. Adaptability of pure breed goat is poor. Population of this breed is very limited in India and is being used for crossbreeding. Pure breed Boyo buck costs about 30 to 35,000 rupees now. Of course, the Beetle goat from Punjab is also equally good. Hence, the farmers need not run behind this Boyo breed. Hence, we can conclude that Shirohi and Talacheri breeds are advisable for common farmers. Boyo, Jamnapari, and other costly breed bucks may be kept for the purpose of crossbreeding. Talacheri Shirohi does and Jamnapari Boyo bucks are good combinations for crossbreeding. Does and bucks mature by 8 to 10 months, but use them for breeding only after 12 months. Does and bucks selected for crossbreeding should have body weight matching to their age. Good ancestry records and stable health are also important. There is no particular breeding season in stall-fed goats, but avoid full pregnancy in hot summer. Excess temperature may cause abortion or premature kidding. Doe comes into estrus again after 18 days of kidding in some breeds, but allow crossing in next heat. Artificial insemination is not popular in goats in India due to less rate of conception. Hence, keep one good buck for 20 to 25 does. Keep two good bucks of different breeds in a herd of 30 to 35 does coming into estrus. Doe in heat will select the buck in which it is interested. In big farms, bucks are shifted from group to group every week. Good does with regular kidding are retained for breeding for 5 to 6 years. But change the buck every year. Otherwise, inbreeding creates retarded growth and many other health problems. Big farmers multiply pure breed goats and sell to new farmers. Common breeds like Shirohi, Talacheri, etc. are sold for 250 rupees per kilogram body weight for breeding purpose. Special breeds like Jamnapari, Boyo and Damascus, etc. are costly and charged animal-wise. Select big does of 40 to 45 kilograms body weight for crossbreeding with Jamnapari and Boyo bucks. Otherwise, doe will face problem in kidding. Newly born kid of Shirohi and Talacheri breed weighs 2 to 3 kilograms, Boyo 4 kilograms and Jamnapari 5 kilograms. Gestation period is 145 to 150 days. Clean the slime in the mouth and nose immediately after the kid takes birth. This is to facilitate easy breathing. Collect the placenta and throw it at a distance from the farm. Kid should suck colostrum within half an hour. This is most important for the development of disease resistance. Kid needs our assistance for feeding for 2 days. Goat produces enough milk even for 2 to 3 kids. 100 ml of milk for 1 kg body weight per day is necessary. That is, if the kid weighs 3 kg, it needs 300 ml of milk per day. Divide this amount into 3 parts and feed in the morning, afternoon and by night. Feed the delivered dough with more fibrous feed. Stop giving oil cakes 1 week before kidding. The kid suffers with indigestion if the fat content of the milk is high and feeding is heavy. Kid may die due to yellow diarrhea. Dough produces surplus milk for 10 days. Take out excess milk by hand. Keep only necessary amount of milk in the udder and leave kids for feeding. Otherwise, kids suck whole amount of milk. If the milk production is too less or the mother dies, feed the kid with goat or cow milk with the help of a bottle with a nipple. Keep the kids with their mother for 10 days. Later on, keep them separate and leave them for feeding thrice a day. Otherwise, the kids will not try to learn eating feed and fodder. Wean the kids after 1.5 months. Milk production continues, even up to next kidding in Thalachery goats. Milk them regularly without fail. Otherwise, it will lead to mastitis. Excess milk production itself is a problem in goats. Mortality of kids goes up with poor feeding management. Mother also gets into trouble. It is better to keep small kids in guardrails like this for 2 weeks. Keep kids in sheds like this in the winter. Electric bulb may be lit to raise the temperature inside. Both does and bucks develop horns. Long horns trouble the goats while feeding in this type of shed. This problem is more in bucks. Hence, dehorn the kid within 10 days with a hot iron rod or caustic potash. Let a trained veterinarian do this delicate job. Likewise, hoof trimming is done immediately after the birth of the kid. Sometimes, the hooves grow again, which needs trimming. Otherwise, it gives trouble in walking. Marking tab may be put to facilitate maintaining records. It is compulsory for insurance. But in this type of shed, the tag locks with the bars and ears get damaged. Good bucks are in great demand. But castrate the other bucks which are not useful for breeding before 5 to 6 months. This helps for better growth and good quality meat production. Now, let us study the feed management in goats. Silage is not so popular in goat farms. Goats are fed with green fodder twice and concentrate once a day. It eats dry fodder like paddy straw, but it is not helpful for growth of the goat. However, the herbages of dicot plants like horse gram, cowpea, black gram, groundnut, etc. are excellent. Improved green fodder varieties like CO4, AP01 and Guinea are used in this farm. Yield and quality of AP01 is better than other types. Hedge lucerne is in mixed cropping with the grasses. This farmer uses brush cutter for the cutting of the grasses. Since the fodder crop is in the vicinity of the goat shed, 4 laborers are maintaining 400 goats. Fodder crop in 1 acre land is sufficient for 30 to 35 goats. Perennial tree fodders like Subabul, Hedge Lucerne, Clericidia, Mulberry, etc. may also be fed. Nutritious green fodder reduces the dependence on concentrated feed. Cost of rearing of a goat comes down. Locally available fruit can be given to goats. 1 kilogram of fodder and 100 grams of feed are necessary for 10 kilograms of body weight. For an adult goat, 4 to 5 kilograms of green fodder and 400 to 500 grams of concentrate is sufficient. Feed may be divided and fed twice with the fodder or separately. 10 grams of mineral mixture per goat per day is compulsory with the feed. cost of ready-made feed is very high. Nutrient content is also not assured. Hence, feed may be prepared on the farm itself. According to animal nutrition experts, feed composition must be like this: broken maize 40%, wheat polish 30%, dicot gram powder 10%, broken rice 10%, and soya bean 10%. Add 1 kg of common salt, 2 kg of mineral mixture, and 1 kg of digestible crude protein or DCP to 100 kg of main feed mixture. Pregnant and delivered does are given normal amount of feed only. It needs more feed if it has more than 3 kids. Generally, small amount of oil cake is mixed in drinking water. Some farmers put common salt also. Goats like this and drink. Silage is the best fodder for goats. Now let us study the scientific method of silage making. Though the silage is useful, it is not yet popular among goat farmers. Yellow maize is grown for silage making. Just after milky grain stage, that is by 85 days, crop is harvested with cobs. Generally, sunken silage pits of this type are in use. Here the stone slabs are used for flooring and wall. It is helpful to control rats. Put thick plastic sheets on all sides of the silo pit. Even the cement or stone pit needs plastic layer. This retains moisture in the silage and prevents air and water entering inside. Silage making is the anaerobic fermentation of fodder. Silage gets spoiled if air enters inside. Cut the fodder with the cob to quarter in size. Let it fall directly into the pit. If the dicot plants are mixed, the nutritive value of the silage will be better. Dissolve 20 kg of jaggery in 150 liters of water in a barrel. Put 50 liters of water in another bowl. Mix 250 grams of silage microorganism culture. Few private labs produce this silage culture mixture. This costs about 13 to 14,000 rupees per kilogram and is sufficient for 100 tons of fodder. This is most important for good quality silage and also for easy digestion. Silage without culture may sometimes create diarrhea in goats. Mix this culture solution into the jaggery water. Sprinkle the solution at the rate of 10 liters per ton of fodder. This farmer has an easy method for sprinkling. This small tub on the top of the platform contains culture solution. Drip irrigation pipe attached to the bottom of the tub brings down the solution. This pipe opens on the top of the shaft cutter and solution is sprinkled automatically. A tap attached to the pipe controls the flow. 1 kg of common salt per ton of fodder is also added. Complete the filling of the silo pit on the same day. Do not continue for the second day. Trample the fodder in the pit by clean bare feet so that the air inside the heap comes out. Cover the pit with plastic sheet to make it airtight. Put stone or sandbags on it. Silo pit with 20 tons of fodder needs 5 tons of weight. Prevent the rain and flood water entering the silage pit. Rats should not burrow inside. This allows air and insect inside, spoiling the silage. This fodder turns into silage after 15 days of filling and keeps up to 2 years. Size of cutting, amount of trampling, and weight on the top decides the quality of the silage. This silage is good even for sheep, cows, and buffaloes. One cubic feet space of the pit holds 12 to 15 kilograms of silage. This pit is 30 feet long, 6 feet wide, and 10 feet deep. that is 1,800 cubic feet. This accommodates 25 to 30 tons of silage. It is difficult to take out the silage if the depth of the pit is more than 10 feet. Do not open the entire silo pit while using the silage. It is better to open 2 to 3 feet of the length of the pit and exhaust up to the bottom. If the pit is opened like this, covering it again is a must after the usage for the day. Silage can be prepared even with rain-fed fodder sorghum varieties like SSV73, PVK01, GD65195 and GD65174. These also yield 10 tons of fodder per acre. Harvest and cut the fodder along with its grains, irrespective of the variety. This contains 10 to 15% of grain by weight. Hence, the goat eating 4 kg of silage will get at least 400 grams of grain. One can escape from using concentrates if this kind of silage is fed. Silage culture used enables easy digestion and increases the availability of nutrients. Goats will not grow like this if it is fed only with green fodder. Indigestion is not seen, even if the goat eats excess quantity of silage. Yellow maize yields 15 tons of biomass per acre. 40 to 50 tons of fodder is available from 3 crops in a year. Each adult goat needs 1 to 1.5 tons of silage per year. So one can raise 30 to 35 goats with 1 acre of fodder. Do not forget to use organic manure and micronutrients to the soil for this continuous crop. Crop rotation is still better. 60 to 65% is the optimum moisture content in the fodder to get good quality silage. If the silage contains more moisture, the goat suffers with a shortage of dry matter. Yellow maize is excellent for silage production, but it will not come up well in high rainfall and low fertility areas. One can go for CO4, Guinea, AP01, or any other improved fodder grass for silage making, or it may be fed as green itself. In this case, 2 kg of jaggery per ton of fodder is advised for good quality silage production. But this silage contains no grains. Hence, feeding concentrates is inevitable. Using silage avoids the hectic work of fodder transportation and cutting every day. This reduces the labor requirement on regular days. Availability of nutrients is more in the silage than green fodder. Goats drink less water. Even then, 4 to 5 liters of water per goat is necessary in hot summer. Water troughs are kept with feeders in the paddock. In some farms, water tubs are kept inside the shed. Goats are given bath once in a week in summer and once in a month during winter. A mixture of lime powder and bleaching powder is spread on the platform and on the floor below once in a month. Then wash the platform thoroughly with water. Give whitewash to the walls at least once in a year. Put 10 ml of 5% formalin in 1 liter of water and spray thoroughly to the shed on all sides. Send the goats out while spraying formalin. All these steps maintain hygienic condition in the shed and thereby keeps the goats healthy. Pellet is the best manure. It has 2.4% nitrogen and 0.88% phosphorus and 1.99% potash. One adult goat produces approximately 500 kg of pellets in a year. Collect the waste fodder and pellets regularly and heap it at a distance. This manure may be used for fodder field or other crops. It has good demand and price. There is one simple method to assess the age of a goat. Like other animals, kid will have milk teeth. Look, these are the milk teeth. Two permanent teeth appear by 12 to 14 months. This goat is in tooth teeth stage. By 18 to 20 months, goat will have another pair of permanent teeth. This goat has 4 teeth. Goat gets 6 permanent teeth by 26 to 28 months. This goat is in 6 teeth stage. Last pair of permanent teeth will emerge by 36 months or 3 years. This goat has 8 permanent teeth, which indicate the completion of growth of this goat. By 7 to 8 years, teeth start depreciating. Goats do not have wool cover like sheep. Here the infestation of ectoparasites like lice, ticks, etc. is more. Goats may be dipped in water tank with suitable chemical. Spraying of the insecticide or injection is also in practice. Deworming is most important for the control of endoparasites. Worm-infested goats suffer from debility and lose weight. Put first dose of deworming medicine at 4 to 7 days stage for newly born kids. Later on, deworm once in a month for 1 year. Deworm the adult goats once in 3 months. Deworm the pregnant doe after 2 months of conception. Deworming earlier to this may lead to abortion. Mark the goats with dye like this after putting the medicine. This is to avoid double dose or missing. Use different medicines each time. Deworming injections and combined medicines for many endoparasites are available now. There are many chemicals and brands. The dosage depends on the body weight of the animal. Hence, it is better to depend on an expert veterinarian for any medication. Test the pellets in the lab once in 6 months for endoparasites. Deworming is most important for good health and growth of goats. Most of the disease of sheep are seen in goats also. PPR, ET, goat pox, FMD, HS, anthrax, etc. are common. Vaccines are available for all these diseases. Prepare a schedule of vaccination and follow it without fail. Hence, the stall-fed goats escape most of these diseases. Treat incidental health problems like cold, cough, fever, wound, etc. as and when required. PPR and ET vaccines are compulsory twice a year for stall-fed goats. Put first dose of PPR vaccine by 2 to 2.5 months to the kid. Booster dose after 17 to 21 days is also necessary. Give first dose of ET vaccine at 2 month stage. Booster dose after 17 to 21 days may also be given. Put HS vaccine to the kid at 3 month stage. Give one dose of PPR vaccine and 2 doses of ET and HS vaccines per year for adult goats. Foot and mouth disease or FMD is more common in goats than sheep. Put FMD vaccines twice a year in outbreak areas. Goat pox is also a dangerous disease. This vaccine once in a year is necessary in infested areas. Makreshwara Goat Research Station of Uttar Pradesh has developed a trial vaccine for goat pox and is found effective. Avoid entry of diseases while bringing goats from other farms and regions. The possibility and intensity of these diseases vary from region to region. Hence, it is better to consult an expert veterinarian of the locality while planning vaccination schedule. Mastitis is one more major problem of goats. Take out the surplus milk and avoid the possibility of mastitis. Regular vaccination avoids all these diseases in stall-fed goats. Goat is a fast-growing animal. It gains 4 kilograms per month in stall feeding with nutritious food and good management. This speed of growth is up to 6 to 8 months age. The meat quality is excellent at 7 to 8 months stage or at 20 to 25 kilogram body weight. Hence, it gets a premium price in demand. Aged goat yields fibrous hard meat. Dressed meat percentage is less in goats used for breeding. Hence, 8 month age is the right stage for culling. A live goat gets half the price of the dressed meat. That means, if the meat price is Rs. 250 per kilogram, live goat gets 125 to 150 rupees per kilogram body weight. Breed, age, body condition, and customer's choice, etc., decide the price of the goats. Traditional goat farming is very common in our country, but the systematic stall feeding system is very rare. Marketability of the goat meat is excellent. Rearing sheep and goat in combination is also good. Though the goat needs more food and attention, its fast multiplication generates more income. We can achieve better with systematic stall feeding in goat farming. This is the right time to reap the best opportunity for goat rearing. Let us hope our farmers will come forward and bring India into the number one position in goat farming in the coming years.